I've kind of laid out everything. One of the things we haven't talked about is whenever I'm working on something, generally I'll go out and I'll take a micro-fiche and I'll print it off and I'll study it. Two reasons for doing this. One, it'll help you identify parts and part numbers that you may need to order and have on hand before the reassembly. Two, you don't always know that the previous owner who put the bike together last, if it's not the factory, did it with the right fasteners, with the right pieces, or in the right sequence. It's always good to have one of these to compare to. Fittings and everything once we get it. Now the engine goes in here, in that space. Okay. All is good. Did not have the replacement seal for this needle bearing, but now I need to get grease in these bearings. So what I'm going to do is pack it from the top, and we'll use the same pressure we would as we had it cupped in our hand earlier. We'll just use that same pressure to force a little bit of the time down into the bearing. I'm forcing the grease down through the small gap between the inner and outer rays. Okay, I can see it coming out the bottom. We've actually forced enough in through the gaps in the bearing, the cage, down through the needle bearings, and I can see it coming up out of the bottom. So I know that the bearing is fully lubricated and greased. We'll spin to make sure that we can see the grease change in direction, and we do. We see it dragging. We're going to replace the balls. There's 22 ball bearings that run on this race. To hold those in place, I'm just going to use a little bit of grease. And what we'll do here, grease that needs to be there anyway. Very important we don't lose any of these. What I did is I cleaned them yesterday. And then, so the grease will lubricate the balls and we'll be there permanently. But right now, the ideal is that it will hold our bearings, the balls in place. Grease is holding the 22 of them. You can see there's no unusual gaps or anything around the uh, around the circle, around the circumference. And this is the reverse of that race. This also has a rounded surface that'll fit down on top of there. Grease on this. Doesn't need a lot, just need enough there to hold it. All right. That completes the bearing you've got. This is our triple tramp assembly. This is our steering head, steering stem. Again, the needle bearings greased, ready to go. The race is already installed in the bottom. Just gonna come up through here and carefully come through that. Now, to that we cap off. We've got a seal and dust cover. And to that, this is actually what we'll use to adjust the tension of the forks. Just from experience, what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna tighten this up. This is a spanner wrench. All right. I'm gonna tighten it up and turn it. I wanna make sure the bearing seat and all the grease and everything's working in it. And this is a little bit tight because I can feel it loosen and tighten and so forth. But, all right, I don't want any play. That has a good solid feel lock to lock. So that entire steering head is adjusted. The bearing on top of that, we put our top triple clamp, and we have a bolt that we'll stick on here. We'll tighten this down to what is probably going to be about 30 pounds, and it'll just keep static pressure. We don't want to do that until we get our fork tubes in the holes. I think now it's time to tighten everything up except the steering head. This is an 8mm bolt, and I know that 8mm bolts typically use a 14 foot-pound torque, so I've torqued that to 14 pounds. And I'll do the same on the lower suspension. Okay, again, 14 foot-pounds. That is a 12mm bolt, so I'm going to go up on the torque. 35 pounds on that one. And we have one more on the bottom here. There's our 14 pounds. And we've got one more sitting right there that we've got to get to. Direct it to the back so that we can run with an eye on lubrication. Next, we've taken our forks. If you remember, we stripped these down with soda blasting and then we painted them silver. We've got new fork boots. Our seal's in good shape, so we did not change those. They're easy to change if you need to. What we'll do is we will now show these going up into the triple clamps. Okay. And this is why we didn't do all that tightening a while ago, so we can get these and get them right. Alright, what I'm going to do here is I know these go to the very top. I'm just going to put finger tightening on them. Should be just enough to hold them. I'm going to do the same on the other side. This is getting to be a... Just that little bit of spinning makes all the difference in the world. Just anything here. Get them near the top, almost flush, and I'll do a hand tightening. So we'll go ahead and okay. Since we've already tightened the triple clamp, I don't want to fully tighten that because remember I've got to do this top bolt. We did not want to do this before. Okay. I'm going to go up to about 25 pounds on this. I'm not sure what the torque is. I will look that up. I'm going to 25 pounds just as a precaution. Now back to 14 pounds. Those are 14 pounds all the way around. Everything's tight. Okay. Don't scratch. Okay.
All right. There you go. There
you got that. Okay. That was easy. The biggest thing is we can put these on there. We're going to assemble this rear wheel on the bike without the brake shoes installed. That is for a different segment, and for the first step, we don't need brakes on this bike.
Those in first.
Yeah, should this side first. This side should have been first because the fact it's got to fit. This one here was designed to go last because it doesn't have a brake. This goes on here with the numbers to the outside. And we have a washer. Goes there. And then that goes there. We do need to adjust this the same. For our purposes, I'm gonna run this tire all the way up. We'll center number three here too, make our whole center. And these eccentric spacers, what's nice about them is that if you get the numbers right and you check that that's true, it's real easy out on the trail, the road, to set them up correctly. I should put it on your side, Brittany. To make sure we have a wheel that's straight and true and not over tight, we spin it and we get a good spin. Okay.